Hey everyone, this is Nick, and I wanted to show you this infographic I saw from Visual Capitalist over on Instagram. One of the things I really loved about this was this beautiful gradient bar chart that has this really deep orange color at the top to show the highest value and kind of morphs down to this really vibrant yellow color to show the lowest value, still really high rents here in the top 10 US rent cities. But I wanted to see if we could make this in a bar chart in PowerPoint on our own. And I think that we can do it by manipulating some of the plot area settings. So let's go ahead over to our bar chart. I have other videos about how to make a bar chart, I'll link above and below. We also just want to fill the plot area here. So you can see if you click inside the chart, you're going to get that plot area activated. The format plot area menu is activated, and under the paint bucket here, the fill options, I'm going to say, instead of no fill, I'm going to say gradient fill. So we're going to go ahead, the gradient fill stops, the template gradient stops sort of pop up here. I'm going to go ahead and drag these gradient stops off of the screen because we just need two stops. I'm going to make sure the type is set to linear and the direction is going to be from top to bottom. So I want the darkest color on top and the lightest color on bottom. So over here for the darkest color, I'm going to click on this. Instead of the blue, I'm going to open this paint bucket menu and click on the eyedropper tool. We're going to go ahead and move that eyedropper over the top bar in our graphic here, and now the top of the gradient is going to be that nice deep orange color. Now the bottom over here, I'm going to do the same thing. We're going to go ahead and click on the eyedropper tool and click on the very bottom bar in that bar chart. Now we have this really nice gradient fill plot area. Now what we need to do is manipulate the chart just a little bit. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to reduce the gap width of my bars to 0%. So click on the bars, go over to the format data series menu under the little bar chart icon here. Gap width right now is set to 30%. I'm going to drag this all the way down to 0%. Now under the paint bucket, I'm actually going to add a little white outline around my bars. So under border, it's set to no line. We're going to say solid line, and we're going to make sure that it is white. Now you can adjust the point value here. I have mine set to 4 points, and I'm going to like that for now. Now the other thing we have to do is now we have to change this from a standard bar chart to a stacked bar chart. And you can see that the very maximum value on my axis here is 5,000. So that's an important number to keep in mind right here. We're going to right click and we're going to open the Excel data source behind this chart. So let's wait for that menu to pop up. And you can see here's my data, or here are my data for the rents in series one. Over here, I'm going to add a helper column. And I'm going to use a formula. We're going to say equals 5,000 minus the cell right next to it. Okay, so equals 5,000 minus the cell next to it. Click enter and it should fill, autofill all the way down. Now, I'm going to click close out of this. Now, this does not look the way that we want it to. It's giving us a clustered bar chart. We want to go ahead and change this chart type on the chart design menu. Change chart type. We're going to go ahead and change this to a stacked bar. Go ahead and change to a stacked bar, click OK. And now you can see that these are my filler bars and these are my actual bars. But what we're gonna do here is we're gonna fill the helper bars with white. So there is a solid white color there, so we don't see anything. And our blue bars, we're going to say no fill. And when we say no fill, that's going to give us the background of the plot area. But the plot area doesn't span the entire way because now we have that helper column, that helper series of data that is covering the rest of that plot area. So if you wanted to go ahead and add some of these labels, we could click in this bar, add data labels here. We can make them really dark, bold, a nice custom font like they have. And then under the format data label options, say inside end, maybe we could do couple notches higher in terms of the font. And there you go. You probably don't need to have this x-axis anymore. Just go ahead and delete it. And there you have a beautiful gradient filled bar chart. And you just took a little bit of hacking behind the scenes to make that happen. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and make sure to hit the subscribe button and the bell next to it. You'll get notified every time I post a new video in data design, usually Excel, PowerPoint, or Word. I had a great time making this for you and I can't wait to see you next time.